Some have described him as complex. Others have described him as hyper-intellectual. There are those who say he is a mulatto of style. Born in 1930 in the city of Castries, Derek Walcott grew up in a humble abode. Derek is the son of Alix and Warwick Walcott. His twin brother was Roderick and his sister Pamela. They grew up with their mother Alix, as their father Warwick, an artiste, died when they were very young. Derek and Roderick were only a year at the time. Consequently, Derek's mother had to take up the challenge of raising her children, and she did so in fine style. Alix Walcott was the principal of the Methodist School in Castries. Derek Walcott received his secondary education at the St. Mary's College. He then won a scholarship to the University of the West Indies in Jamaica to do what he called an indifferent degree in French, English, and Latin. From that point onward, he began to develop his art of poetry. Walcott's interest in poetry developed from a young age. His mother was a major source of inspiration and support. She encouraged him to read and write poetry from a very early age. His mother was herself an amateur actress reciting Shakespearean verses. This gave Derek the impetus to pursue his love for literature and poetry. His mother was so supportive that she gave Derek $200 so that he could publish his first major book entitled 25 Poems. The book was published in 1947. Derek took those books and went to sell them on the streets on his own. Derek was also a playwright, and he completed his first play, Henri Christophe, in 1950. The play was based on the revolutionary character from Haiti. Also in that year, Derek founded the St. Lucia Arts Guild, a theater group which performed the play as its first production. After Walcott completed his first degree in 1953, he went to Trinidad and Tobago. There he started his career in journalism at the Trinidadian Guardian. He also wrote for public opinion in Jamaica. In 1958, Derek Walcott went off to New York to study poetry. Walcott then decided to remain in the United States of America, where he became a professor of poetry at the University of Boston, where he still lectures. Consequently, Walcott divides his time between Trinidad and the United States. Derek Walcott has European and African blood running in his veins. His grandfather was Caucasian. This mixture has in turn contributed to the mulatto of stars, evident in his poetry. He puts his situation rather elegantly in poetry.
I, who am poisoned with the blood of both, where shall I turn? Divided to the vein. I, who have cursed the drunken officer of British rule, who choose between this Africa and the English tongue I love.
This is from his poetry, A Far Cry from Africa. It can also be seen in the following quote from the epic poem, Homeros.
I'm just a red nigger who loved the sea. I had a sound colonial education. I have Dutch, nigger, and English in me. And either I'm nobody or I'm a nation.
Derek Walcott continues to lecture in Boston and comes to the Caribbean on a regular basis. He still writes plays and poems based on the Caribbean region. Walcott is a man who is well respected and is one who has much to offer to budding literature students and poets.